Mr. Marandi, now the IAEA's report will reportedly raise concern that Iran's nuclear facilities are not for peaceful purposes. Of course, Tehran has always maintained that they are. Now, is this fair comment? I mean, we're still waiting for the report to come out, or is this all just a pretext for war?
Well, I doubt that any war will take place because Israel is a much smaller country than Iran, and Iran's strength lies in its missile deterrence. And at the same time, the United States is in no position to initiate a war. I think it's mostly the intention is to put pressure on Iran and also to put pressure on other countries, independent countries like China and Russia and others, to agree with new sanctions by sort of portraying Israel as a mad dog, attack dog that needs to be somehow controlled. And if they agree to new sanctions, something bad will be prevented from happening. But the whole report itself, it's based on forged documents. There is absolutely nothing new in the report. All the documents that are supposed to come out are from the year 2004 and before. And El-Baradei, his assessment was completely in opposition to what the new head of the IAEA is making. The documents were based on an electronic file on a laptop, if you recall, a few years ago. This all goes back to then.
Okay.
The Iranians said that the file is forged. Yes.
Okay, yeah, but just going back to what you were saying earlier, you don't think that it's really likely and that this report is based on past or obsolete documents. But then again, we just go back to what the Israeli president had warned last week. He said that a strike on Iran's nuclear facilities is increasingly likely. Then what is that based on then? Could we really see military action from Israel and its allies based on what he said?
As I said, it's highly unlikely because the Israelis would really lose in any confrontation. Iran's strength is in its missile deterrence, and Israel is not prepared to for any Iranian counterstrike. The Iranians would have every right to do so.
Why even say something
like
that?
I think if you look at the general picture, there is a general trend to try to put Iran in a corner, to try to corner Iran. If you recall, just a few weeks ago, the Americans made outrageous accusations about some murder plot of the Saudi ambassador to the United States. No one in the world believed it because it was so absurd. This now comes right after that. This report, if you look at the Western media, the corporate media, they're all saying that this is new information. It proves that Iran is trying to produce nuclear weapons, where in reality, all the documents go back to 2004 and the previous years. All have been refuted in the past. The United States has never provided the IAEA with the documents. This shows that this is basically an attempt to create a pressure and to move public opinion
against Iran. Yeah, but outrageous though those statements may be, I mean, as much as you say that they're outrageous, why are they doing it now? I mean, they're upping the pressure right now. What does the timing have got to do with anything, if any?
Well, I think a lot of it has to do with the rapidly declining fortunes of the United States in the Middle East and throughout the world. The U.S. economy is on the decline. The United States has many troubles at home. This is reflected in the demonstrations that are taking place in many parts of the United States. This is a good way to distract attention away from its own problems. The United States is losing its foothold in the Middle East through the uprisings and the awakenings. And in fact, if an attack was really going to take place, this would really move public opinion in this region, which is so, which is changing so much, in favor of Iran and against the United States. So the United States doesn't gain anything by this. And in fact, I think it basically discredits the United States even further, because this dishonest portrayal of the situation by the corporate media, by the United States, is something that people can see through nowadays.
Okay, you were talking earlier about Iran's strength in its deterrent capability, but we also have to look at Israel's security, the importance put on Israel's security. How threatened does Iran feel by all sorts of aggressive rhetoric that's coming its way?
I don't think that the Iranians feel concerned at all. As I pointed out, Israel doesn't have the capability to carry out a major attack on the country. Yet Israel is highly vulnerable
to any
Iranian counterstrike.
Well, we have Israel and the support of the U.S., for example, if it's not just Israel here going up against Iran.
Well, again, three things really. One is that the documents themselves show to the world, to public opinion outside of the West especially, that this whole situation is based on a dishonest foundation. And that will not work to the well for the United States. B, the United States, if it carries out any attack, or Israel, it will create heavy problems for the global economy. It could bring about a complete meltdown. Even if the United States tries to impose new sanctions, the Iranians will definitely retaliate in the ways that it can to hurt the United States and those countries that try to impose pressure on Iran. So it's not going to benefit the United States and global public opinion, especially the people in the region which are in the midst of these uprisings, will turn against the United States.
All right. Thank you very much for your time there and for
your
insight, Professor Saeed Mohammad Mirandi from the University of Tehran.